Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Xerath Prevails, an alternate accounts story. In this case, sometimes it's a Grand Arena story. It's always a Grand Arena story, but I recently made it into top 10 for my alt, and it was the first season that I was actually trying to do that, because I had to do all the feats and everything to be able to make it in, but make it in I did. And just barely, but top 10 is top 10. I realize that Division 3 is not Division 1 by virtue of them being entirely different words. But Division 3 can still be very challenging. Lots of good players in Division 3. And frankly, I just wanted to talk a little bit about the different factors that contributed to me getting into top 10. There are quite a few important factors. If you want to go see my battles, if you want to see my matchup decisions, please feel free to go watch all of those fights. They're entertaining to some degree, at least, and whatever. But what I'm going to talk about is more big picture stuff here today. So without further ado, let's talk about... First, let's actually talk about my patrons. I haven't been including you guys in my videos lately for some reason. I'm in my transition from phone to desktop, so I apologize for that, but I truly appreciate you patrons. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for the support for this channel. And so the thing that I really focused on in this on this account for my alt is trying to control my matchup GP. And what that means is, real quick, I'll show you guys so you can see I have 3.5 million GP. And that number isn't significant on its own. However, the thing that you'll notice if you scroll down, now the top part is just my favorites list, so I have a ton of projects I'm working on, as you can see, an irresponsible level. But once you get to my top characters, I do have quite a few gear 13s, but none of them have high relic levels. The highest relic level is 3. Most of them are just 1, or sometimes in the case of Jolie is at 0. And honestly, I think that 0 is a better choice in terms of efficiency. But what happens is, when you go into a matchup, when you go into the matchup phase of Grand Arena, you end up getting paired with people with the same number of GP, of matchup GP as you. That's very different from your total GP or even your character GP. So let's switch to this here. This is just a stat sheet that I pulled from one of my main account matches on Hotbot. Now you can see on the top there, it's kind of distracting actually on the bottom. Don't look at the gear or the Zetas or anything. But what we're looking at is toward the top, you can see on the left is me, on the right is my opponent, and it says top 80 GP, top 65, and then character GP, ship GP, whatever. But those two, the top 80 and top 65, are the numbers that really matter for these matchups. You can see that the top 80, that's what they use for when we're doing 5v5 and we don't have any ships, because that's the number of characters you would need to deploy and the number of characters you would need to have a perfect win with 5 characters on each team. And so that's what they use to determine our matchmaking, to determine who is going to fight against who. And frankly, you can control that by quite a bit, by a huge margin actually, because you're going to get paired against someone with a similar top 80 GP or top 65. I think in this case, we got matched up at top 65. It can be a little bit difficult to conceptualize the idea of top 80 GP, top 65. It essentially just takes the 65 characters that you have that have the most GP, and it adds them all up. And it compares them to all the other people who have registered, and they're added together, top 65 characters, and it smashes them together. So if your top 65 characters all have Relic 7, you're going to be paired against someone with a very similar score, and probably all Relic 7, something like that. However, there's some differences in all of this because things like Zetas tilt the balance a little bit. Like, I have a Grandmaster Yoda lead Zeta that's been screwing me for months in Grand Arena because I never use him, but he's in the top 65 and the top 80, and it's 2.5K. Matchup GP. So, my opponents that I get matched up against who don't have that Zeta have an advantage because they might have a couple extra relic levels or something. It doesn't matter how you get the GP. What it matters really is how you end up getting paired against someone. Zetas are a pretty big factor. The mods can be a big factor. Your gear level and relic levels all matter quite a bit. And frankly, I don't want to go on at length about this. I've talked about it before, but relics are incredibly inefficient for GP. For bang for your buck, getting one relic level is just not great for your overall matchup GP, as opposed to gear. All the gear pieces, all the way up to gear 13, are super efficient. Like, you can place, I think, like 4 or 5 pieces of gear for every relic level that you apply. So it's not even close. And so if you want the most impact to your roster, you just add a lot of gear 13 to your roster. So that's kind of been my focus. And now let's just look at one of my matchups, and I can show you kind of the differences in my account, some of the focuses. You can see that my relic levels are all really low. I have 3 tier 3 relics, and other than that, they're all tier 2 or tier 1, really low. I focused on putting Zetas on characters. I've focused on putting a lot of gear on characters. You can see my gear 13 is way higher than my opponent's by 7, which is a big deal at this level. And my mods are especially good. We can zoom in on them. That my mods are I beat my opponent bloody on mods. They're not it's not even close, and that is a huge factor. Mods make or break a GAC match. Absolutely, you should absolutely take a look at that. So now I'm going to show you guys a couple of my matches here, a couple of my fights. So one factor to all of this, beyond the top 65 GP, you want to be efficient. That's obvious, I think, at this point. Pretty obvious. You need to have experience to be able to pick the matches that will win. There's not a lot of margin for error. In top 10, you have to get a pretty close to perfect score most of your matches. If you fail very many fights, it's going to be very difficult to recover enough banners. My margin of error, the person ahead of me for number 7, I was number 8. The person in number 7 was less than 20 away, so that's one failed attack away from me moving up a spot. It's very competitive at the top levels, and you really have to watch yourself. Another aspect to all of this is look at these opponents' defenses. There's a little bit of RNG luck in what your opponent sets, and the thing is, it all comes back to matchup GP. If you know what you're doing and you are getting all of the efficient characters and you're putting gear on them efficiently, then you're going to end up succeeding a lot more. You can see that Leia here has her Zeta, that's not good. Phasma has her Zeta, not good. Acolyte and Talia at this level, at this GP, have gear 12, that's also not efficient. And I just don't know what they're doing with their roster here. Honestly, I don't, not to be rude, but look at this. Dooku has his Zeta, Savage, Vader has some Zetas. Like, Veers is good, but he's with Magna Trooper. Like, you're just going to face some pretty poor opponents sometimes. That's just how it happens, and you just have to be able to take advantage of it, I guess. So we're gonna speed run through some of these matches because honestly, I went 12-0. You can watch all of these fights on your own. I'll speed to the really interesting ones toward the end, where your matches start getting harder. But frankly, A lot of these matches were fights that I'd never done before. You just need to know your roster. If you can practice, however you can practice, it's going to be good. If you can watch other people play well, that's awesome. Now, one factor that always annoyed me was people telling me that you need to use Nest to be able to get yourself to top 10, and that is accurate, honestly. Being able to use Nest, especially in 3v3, is amazing. I used Nest almost every match to be able to get a 55 banner win, and that's just amazing. Using one character to kill an entire team, really efficient. If you can find that, especially in 3v3, that's wonderful. Now you can see that here Nest is with Obi-Wan and R2 because there's a feat that you have to do to be able to get all your points. You need to get all your points so you can find a team that Nest can solo and then just stash these other two characters with them. So just a quick montage of that. Now at the very end of all of this, I faced a couple people with Darth Revan and Malak and Bastila, and they're all reliced, and it can be incredibly challenging for this account. I don't have Darth Revan. I don't have General Skywalker. I don't have a good counter to this. No Galactic Legends. And so you have to make do with what you have. And sometimes you just have to two-shot a team. You have to recognize that your teams aren't going to be able to get there all on their own. And in this case, I kind of got lucky. My opponent, if he had put Darth Revan here, I don't know that I would have been able to actually get the clear here, or at least I probably could have gotten the clear, but I don't know if I could have ended up being efficient enough to beat my opponent. However, they made the mistake, they put Emperor Palpatine, and Palpatine's a great lead, don't get me wrong, but he's no Revan, he's no Darth Revan. So I took out Bastila and Palpatine, and then eventually Darth Malak just bested me. I'm not going to show the madness there, but I was able to then use my Gear 10 Kylo with Watt, and Watt is a huge advantage, if I haven't said that already. He's a huge advantage in 3v3. In Division 3, not many people have him still, and I do have him. He's less than 7 stars, but I do. So you can finish Malak off, and what you need to have a plan. You just need to have a plan. I take everything for offense on my alt, because I don't want to have one of those situations where I can't full clear. If you want to get top 10, 100% need to full clear all 12 rounds. You have to win all 12, and you have to full clear, and that means taking your best teams for offense. So you can see here, I did get to full clear on that opponent. This is my round 11, so almost at the end of the match, and my opponent ended up being pretty efficient. They only failed one attack on me, and that attack happened to be on my Palpatine Bastila team on defense. And honestly, my defenses are just designed to trip you up. They are not designed to get full a hold every single time, except for my negotiator, which is always on defense, which is also difficult at this GP to be able to counter. I'm not saying that it's realistic to try to emulate that for every account, but it was a huge factor having the negotiator on defense. In this fight, actually, I took negotiator. It was the only time I took negotiator. I scouted my opponent. They had malevolence, which they always put on defense, and my Ackbar team was not going to beat their malevolence. So I took my negotiator instead and was able to one-shot it, which is another factor. Scouting is really important, though I did not scout very much on my alt account. I don't like to scout. And now I'm going to show you guys another factor here. Luck is huge to getting into top 10. Look what they use. They use Luke and Chewie and Ezra to try to beat my Palpatine team. They did have Han available, and he was just on another team and probably could have just one-shot me with that Bastila team and Han, but they didn't, and so I won, and I regret nothing. So I moved on to the finals, and it was a pretty it, this opponent does not have a really high GP, but look at their Darth Revan team. They have Relic 7 on Bastila as well, and Marauder, or I don't remember now off the top of my head, but they put their Darth Revan and Malak on there, and the Relic 7, really challenging, almost impossible for my account to be able to counter that. The Relic levels are just unreal. So you get to see a montage of fails here. I ended up failing with 14 different teams, or rather 13 different teams, before I finally was able to get any kind of traction at all and get a win. So you can see I blundered here. I tried to call Yoda to assist, and he can't assist against Darth Revan, so he died. And one thing I want to point out here, so I had to do a feat. You need to always be paying attention to your feats. I needed to do a feat where I had Chewie and Rebel Officer Leia to get a win against something, and so I put 3PO here instead of Chewie because I couldn't assist with Chewie anyways against Darth Revan. And I'll show you guys, there'll be a little thumbnail on the bottom right here eventually with the attack from Rolo, because I got top 10. It's not, I did eventually clear this Darth Revan team, so it's not a secret exactly that I won. I am showing you guys a lot of my fails here. So see on the bottom right here that Rolo and Chewie were able to take out a team. Chewie just one-shot someone. Rolo's only one. She's only one star. No, gear one. So anyways, I was wasting a ton of teams. Ended up needing to try to burn some specials on the Darth Revan team to be able to make sure that if I sent in, I only had one good team left. I had Grievous left. And if Grievous couldn't do it, then I was screwed. So I sent in a bunch of burner teams like that to get all of their specials out of the way and make sure that Grievous had as much time without fear as possible. So you can see that I was just trying to kill Darth Revan. If I could kill Darth Revan, then I could deal with the other two. So I ended up just using one big hit on Revan with Grievous, and that ended up being able to take him out. Now they'll have leadership for this fight, but not the rest of the fight. So I finally did manage to take out Sith Trooper. I couldn't kill Malak. He eventually just died. I timed myself out because I did some damage to him, and then I knew he was just going to heal right away, so I left him at this health level. Then I did my Kylo Ren Unmasked trick to be able to just take him out, and frankly, this is pretty nerve-wracking. It's Relic 7 Malak. He's just got a ton of hit points. The funny thing is, I got 24 banners there, and I only dropped 30 total after I killed 14 teams to do that. And then in the back, there was nothing at all. It was so great to see that. My opponent clearly hadn't given me any kind of respect, anything approaching respect, for that match. He figured I couldn't clear it, and he was almost right, honestly. So if we're being honest, he was almost right. But one thing I want to point out here is this Vader squad, I needed to be able to get kills with Imperials who fought on Hoth, which is pretty tough at this GP, and so I'm taking Thrawn lead. Now, the thing is, if I wanted to, I'm taking low damage on the Shore Trooper. I'm taking Gear 8 Thrawn, and then my Gear 10 Vader, and so if I want to, I can use the event special to be able to defer a turn and hopefully pass it to Vader and get the 3 kills that I needed. I think in this case I only needed 2 total, but you can see I immediately went back. This was a big feat. If I failed to get this feat, I also couldn't have made top 10. And so I did make the feat, and I ended up getting a full clear against my opponent, and I was going to win because he couldn't clear my fleet, because Negotiator is really good at GP 3.5 million. And now I'm just claiming all of my feats. I've saved all my feats, done a ton of feats. I mean, that's really, in a way, getting top 10 is all just about who can finish all of the feats. That's almost all it is, honestly. It's frustrating how that works, but It is what it is. So you can see after all of my feats and everything, I was at rank 3. I ended up getting nudged to rank 7 and eventually got nudged to rank 8, though I didn't record that apparently. And I ended up with a Kyber Contender title for my troubles. So well compensated, really great result, obviously. I always want to get top 10 if possible. Even on my main, I try for that. Even though it's not really that possible for my main because I have too many relic levels on my characters, and I am facing characters and players who are extremely invested in the game, and I'm going to lose. I'm going to fail against some of that. I'm going to fail to get a feat. I'm going to fail to get a perfect full clear. And that's just that. And honestly, folks, that's about it. I know that we were kind of all over the place today. I apologize for that if that was frustrating. My videos are available to watch. They're all on a playlist, so you can find them pretty easily. All my decision making is in there. The thing I wanted to show you guys were just a couple of the factors that contributed to me being able to get into top 10. You need to do feats. You need to get every point possible. In this case, I did not get the feat for Wampa or having Hermit Yoda. And that ended up being okay because other people at my GP level also probably didn't have that, though the people at the very top did get every single point available almost. You need to maximize your wins. You can't just get a full clear. I know that sounds almost impossible to get 12 full clears in a season anyways. It's possible. I've done it before on my main account and on this account. It's very difficult, and what's even more difficult is trying to be super efficient while you're doing it. So just focus on that, all right? I think the biggest thing is trying to control your top 65, your top 80 characters, trying to be as efficient as possible and have as deep of a roster as possible. That's something I didn't really mention. If you have more than 65 characters available that are actually usable, that's great because you're not actually like paying for them. They're kind of free characters, and if they have a lot of utility, then you have a lot more options going into Grand Arena. You can set defenses that are more customized to your opponent and just try to muscle your way past them with a really deep roster. My opponent at the end had one really strong squad, and the rest of his squads were pretty mediocre. Some gear 12 and everything, but Relic 7, that's another strategy though. If you can force your opponent to try to get through your Relic 7, then and they can't, then you just win by default. I don't really like that strategy. Obviously, I was able to eventually get through, and now I'll have General Skywalker, so that shouldn't be an issue anymore. But that is just it's another factor. So I think that's it, folks. I hope it wasn't too all over the place for you. It's over now. If you have questions, please hit me up in the comments. Go join my Discord server, which is in the video description. Check out the counter sheet that I maintain. That's also in the video description. And there's a lot of good resources in the video description, honestly. So go check that out. That includes my Patreon. And if you want to support my channel, I would really appreciate it. You get benefits from it as well. And stay tuned for next season, which is 5v5, which is a superior mode to 3v3, in my opinion, though I do like 3v3. 5v5 is going to be exciting and fun. And I'm going to be doing it for my main and for my alt. I'm also considering making another account and doing like kind of a long-term how-to series. And if you guys are interested in that, I would love to hear from you. I would love feedback on that and see what kind of demand there is. And if like 3 of you tell me that I should do it, then I probably will, because I really want to try it anyways. I don't know what the time frame on it is, though. So I am going to let you go, finally. I really appreciate you guys watching. Thank you all so much for it. And remember that in all things, Xerath's alt prevails, especially in getting top 10, which is seriously, legitimately kick-ass of him. That guy is amazing.